was the most controversial census in Australian history. A new online system was set to revolutionise census. Instead, it was the digital disaster that left 14 million Australians unable to lodge their results.
The website crashed and was hit by three cyber attacks and caused a privacy panic. A Senate inquiry followed and computer giant IBM was ordered to pay more than $30 million in compensation to taxpayers. But now the results are in and it paints a picture of Australia today. Social analyst Mark McCrindle joins us live at the desk. Mark, lovely to see you.
Absolutely.
Now, so many issues collecting this information. So, I mean, is it accurate? Can we say it's accurate information?
We can. In the end, they got 96% of all households to complete the form, which marries up pretty much to what we saw in 2011. Fewer than expected filled it in online. So about 58% online. There was thought that it would be about 65%, but you need about 93% to get that accuracy standard, and they're well above that. So in the end, you know, solid results.
Yeah, excellent. That is good news. All right, the results are in. What are they telling us about Australia's population?
Well, that we're growing and that we're ageing. That's probably one of the key themes. The average age has ticked up from 37 to now 38. And in some states like Tasmania and South Australia, the average age is into the 40s. In other states like the Northern Territory and the ACT, it's early 30s. So quite a wide age range across Australia, but ageing all over the country.
Okay, and who is what we'd call the typical Aussie then?
Well, it's more women than men. So she would be a 38-year-old, married with two children. That's what the data tells us. And most likely living in a three-bedroom home, two cars, juggling, you know, a lot of the realities of life today, but most likely born in Australia as well.
All right, how have we changed?
Pretty significantly, particularly when you look over, say, a century, 100 years, we're a lot older than we were back then. In fact, if you go back a century, the average Australian was a male, now female. We back then, average age 24, now 38, as we said. Most likely, well, far bigger. There are more people that live in Sydney now than lived in the whole country back then. So less than 5 million a century ago, 24 million today. And living a lot longer as well. Larger households then than now, but living about two decades longer, so good news there.
And what does it sort of tell us about diversity? We're becoming more diverse?
Yeah, far more. And that was a big change in this census results here as well. You've got now states like New South Wales that for the first time for those born overseas, they're most likely to have been born not in England but China. And if you look at Victoria, the new number one for overseas-born Victorians is India, not England. So that Anglo shift has come through the data and increasingly, you know, connected to Asia.
Yeah, excellent. Mark, housing affordability is something of a subject and a concern right across the country. What are these results saying about housing affordability?
Well, it's showing that increasingly we're more likely to own a home with a mortgage. In fact, that's the average now. 10 years ago, the most likely Australian was owning a home outright. Now there's still a mortgage to pay off, and that's true across most states and territories. And just with the increasing population, there's more demand for housing than there is supply, and so we're falling a little bit behind in terms of paying off those mortgages.
Mm-hmm. With all the mortgages, the banks are happy, aren't
yes,
they?
Yes, that's right. They're the winners out of this. So who will use this data now and these results? What will they be used for?
Well, the great thing is it's sort of a mirror for us all to look at who we are as a nation. So, you know, all Australians will no doubt access it, certainly have access to it, and businesses and local community organisations tells them about their areas. But more than that, GST distribution is based on this. Electoral boundaries are all done based on the census. And, of course, how money is spent at all levels of government. When we need new schools or hospitals or new infrastructure, it's all based on the data of the census. So it's pretty important every 5 years to get this update.
Absolutely. Okay, Mark, thank you very much.
Thanks,
lovely
Mark.
To see you.